She said, my boy, I think someday you'll find a way to make your learning difficulties pay. You'll be a game dev. You have a talent for churning out shit. Son, be a game dev. Gamers will pay you for producing it. You're just too damn fat for the army. And college ain't meant for retards. Son, be a game dev. God knows it ain't hard.
Here he is, folks, the leader of the team. Watch him go lie at E3, oh my god. He's a game dev, but he'll never ever be any good. Who wants a game made by untalented hacks? Hey, there's bugs. This game's not done.
Ah, shut up, trust us, guys. Patches will come. I am your game dev. And I enjoy the career that I've picked. I am your game dev. And I get off on my games being shit. In this job, I pretty much can't lose. Cause I'm the guy faking all of the user reviews, game dev. And although I may be an evil retard, even if the masses are all against me, shills will still defend my games for free. Cause I'm a game dev, and that shit ain't hard. Say 10. 10. Say 10.
Okay, 10.
Say 10.
10.
Now swallow.
All right, here we are. Someone else actually called this. Well, excuse me. I'm going to bring them in.
Ooh. Cool.
Yep.
Gonna get to have a friend.
Yep, you get a tomato, possibly, if he's around. Tomato, hello.
Hello. Hey, man. Hello.
Hello.
Hello. You're a little quiet. Hello.
That's just probably Skype hating my mic again.
Yeah, probably.
I can hear him okay. I don't know about the stream, but...
Just a little quiet. But, yep. Password.
Yeah, well, I'll do the old-fashioned fix and speak louder.
Yep.
Maybe Skype will understand.
Yeah, that's a little better. Or, that is pretty better. Oh, your man marking carried over in the X word. I forget it does that in 17.
Did they want man marking?
Yeah, they want Lollibaba Science Goblin to mark Putis.
Oh man.
You cannot move players, manager, because that's something you have to do in the nightly. Oh, here's your conditions. I'm sorry.
Well, this—I mean—they must have sent the nightly. This looks different from what they did yesterday.
Yeah, they just wanted to move Madoka a little tiny bit, but you got to do that in your nightly.
Oh man, you don't have to be so stickler for the rules. You can move them.
Yeah, I do.
These are—I mean, it's the VGL. You know that this is where people learn, and if they make mistakes, you should let them fix it.
Yeah, you gotta have consequences for your mistakes.
I thought this was supposed to be the fun league with no rules.
It is fun. You just gotta. It is a learning experience here.
Look at all this red. I mean, you wonder why you know so few people sign up for teams is because there's all this red tape with rules and all this regulation.
VGL, well known for their red tape with rules.
Hey man, I mean, there's literally an independent council to verify people, and I think that's just a little bit
okay.
That's
a
bureaucracy right there.
We're pretty strict on that, but I mean, like 3 people have ever failed that. It's not hard, but I think TF2G just going on sub by ability. They're good. The MMM are good. We've got the Cube ball.
Yes.
Oh, nice.
I don't know if they have a stadium. I didn't see one, or recognize one anyway. Like that's Love Live.
Yeah, I don't see one.
I don't know if that's it.
Everything is fire.
I
am curious. What is this pitch? I want to see what this pitch is.
I have no idea what this is even for Fire Offer.
Let's do it. Let's use it.
All right. Somebody beep me and tell me what the proper thing is. Otherwise, we'll go to that. Let's see what it is.
Or maybe that's like the pitch we're not supposed to use or something.
Oh,
I don't know. But
the manager says it's the U Stadium, so it's Sai Michael Joshi Gakuin.
Oh, okay. Well, PMMM being all lesbians, I don't know. Maybe hello. There's no lesbian undertones in Madoka.
Madoka, no, not at all.
There are absolutely
no lesbians because that is degeneracy. How dare
yes.
you? All right, I'm gonna change a kit here. Do TF2 have more kits? Yeah. Oh yeah, they have the meme kits. So.
Yes, the meme kits.
You want to put them on a meme kit? We can put them on this one.
Yeah, sure. Why not? The story about that is in the first time TF2G played, I guess we didn't have kits or something, so like
no.
That was the kit that was given.
Yeah, the kits got they were meme kits made by our favorite Dr. Detroit.
And kit one and kit two is something I just didn't paint.
Yep. All right, let me get music ready. And TF2G. There we go. All right. Let's do this. Puella Magi versus Team Fortress. Well, things started out pretty usual. I came home, hugged my bride, and she told me she was preparing dinner. Turkey, a favorite of mine. As long as it's over an open fire.
It's one of those other copy pastas that break the game.
Yep.
It's too long for the game.
Courtesy of Ace Attorney Online. Alright, here we go. Anthems.
Hey guys, it's Silky again. I've just been ruling my kingdom. It's been pretty sweet. Except for one problem. It's lonely being a king. Where are all the good girls? So much trash around. I just want someone to cuddle. I just want someone to play with. I just want someone to congratulate me on a good frag. I just want my boom boom queen. Let's go. Welcome to the Silky Dating Show. There are three doors, where do you wanna go? Door 1 has the best player in game. Door 2 has the king of rich and fame. Door 3 has the most sensitive guy. So open one up and give your look at mine.
Brings me great pleasure to see Kyubey being kicked around as a ball. Absolutely.
I don't know. That might work. I mean, that might work against PMMM if they kick around their
No, this is exactly the
magic.
Power they need. It's
I'm
fine.
Sure,
he has a lot of bodies or whatever.
Yeah, I never got that. I guess he has, like, he's like an entity or something. He's like a...
Yeah, he's... I don't know. All I know is every time he's on screen, I scowl. By instinct. I hate him so much.
Become Megumi.
No,
the simple explanation is that it's magic.
He's an alien or something. Fucking whatever.
I guess just to remind everyone, PMM has to win this to advance. Well,
yeah, it's pretty simple. PMMM win, they're through. TF2G draw or win, they're... Well! Putis Kyubey in the goal! It's 1-0 for TF2G right off the bat.
Deal.
Well, early start for TFTG, and that is not super great for Madoka, because now they're in the hole, and they need two goals now.
Well, I mean, Madoka can do concession changes. I thought they wanted to change where Madoka was. You can, I mean, if you guys want to do that, then you guys can do that for free.
Oh, yeah. Yep, you're free to do that now. Well, yeah, I can do that now if you'd like, as a concession. It's still fairly close, but I put you on +1 as you requested, at least, Madoka.
That's a free early +1.
Oh, they need
Pootis! Oh boy.
No.
Oh boy, that's a Pootis brace! It's 2-0 for TFTG. Going to take that opportunity to move the players down. Alright, so move Madoka. Let's see. A little to the left and a little down. Alright.
Oh man. Isn't this how the anime starts? Like it's all gloomy at the beginning, but
it is definitely the end of the world at the beginning of
Yes, and then, you know, by the end of this, Madoka's gonna wish that soccer never existed and then this entire cup would never happen.
Alright, and move Eroha down. Alright.
She'll wish that the VGL never existed, that therefore there would never be any VGL teams to lose against, so...
The 4CC never existed. We all went and had much more productive lives.
Yes.
You're 2 down, but all you need to do is just, when the halftime hits, just grab that ball and bring the ball back to your... quarters and make a simple contract, and all will be fine.
Yep, you just need to wish to win.
Yeah.
And it will happen.
It makes me wonder, do you think, like, every time, like,
might have been 3, but it was blocked by the keeper.
Yeah, I'll wait for this corner to resolve before I say, because I don't want to interrupt anything.
You don't
want to
curse him, is what you're saying. Oh, it was a defender who actually blocked it, but it'll still be a corner.
Yeah.
Also, we have an invisible ref. I'm not sure
why. I was wondering what that was about.
It's a good thing we have that circle. And it's
Oh boy.
It's going to be this again, eh? All right, it's 3-0.
These crosses are just killing them.
Timeout, as expected, out of Madoka.
Man, I was gonna say, like, do you think Homu has gone back in time like several times before this game? But like every time she plays this game, it just turns out like they lose or something.
Yeah, this is not the best timeline yet.
I mean, they haven't lost yet, but it doesn't look very good so far. But you know,
when you need to win, that's a mountain. As we have already seen today.
Yeah.
Defensive line 3 out of 10. There you go. They're going to go Lang Ball. And too wide. Anything else for you, Fola Magi? Walpurgis match, yes. Exactly.
Walpurgis.
Alright, they're good. They're going to try and see if this Lang Ball will help them out a little bit, and they're going to sit more back as well. Nope, we're 3-0 for TF2G under 20 minutes.
Yeah, this has been a total rout.
Usually I am not very happy about changes early, but
These are necessary changes, yeah.
Yeah, you have to win. You have to score 4 goals.
At least, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, I think trying all... here. Here's Aquahomu. Aquahomu is tackled by the defense.
No foul there.
No, I think they called it now. A took a little delay. No, actually, it's Madoka who gets called.
Oh wow!
This
is
some ref ball right here. Come on.
Oh man, I thought this could be on what's her face, Homu.
Yeah, I did too, but no, apparently not. There's Juan Raul putting it over to Kurt Cobain. Misses that kick.
Okay.
Excuse me?
I'm not sure what he was doing there, yeah.
It was like, I think Pottis went for a nutmeg there. Some really impressive passing, and then that happens.
Yeah.
Not quite the right decision, no.
Maybe. This
Kurt Cobain's too much of a genius for us to understand him, you know?
Yeah.
He's a musical god. Oh, we're...
5v1 me faggot. 5v1 me faggot into crutch! It's cleared!
Oof.
I think Madoka
at
finally...
At least it's starting to look better for them. They're actually getting attacks.
They've woken up, finally.
Yeah, that's... I mean, that is a good thing about being down, like... I mean, if there's anything good about being 3 down, is if you're down 3-0 early, you have a lot of time to make it up.
Kurt Cobain's gonna get it on the outside of the box. It's saved by Guantanamo Bay! It's cleared by the defense! It's a little difficult to see what was going on because Putis.
Yeah, Putis has really big feet, so it's really hard to tell where his, like, model is supposed to be.
Misses that header. Oh. Kurt Cobain misses the header. It's out for a goal kick.
But yeah. I mean, look at these crosses. These crosses are just so dangerous for against PMM.
Yeah, the only thing that's basically kind of keeping them alive at this point is TF2 has actually started missing on these chances.
Yeah.
Madoka Magical were able to get to that ball before it went out, but...
Oh, this could be good!
But here's 5v1 me faggot! No!
Oh no.
Homu, why? Why would you...
Aquahomu couldn't get her head on that quite right, and it just kind of sailed by.
Aquahomu, breaker of hearts. Breaker of hopes. Look at this.
Yeah, I think she mistimed that by just like a second.
Yeah.
So it hit the back of her head more. And TF2 are coming up to the wing. Pyro update fucking never back on the pitch after his red card first match. And kind of fucks it up there, putting it right into 300 Magia chips.
I gotta say, I do like that floating. Maybe one of our refs should just be like the 4CC logo, just like hover around like this. It's pretty it's pretty fun to see. The Clover logo just hovering around.
Yeah. Easy mode support. Cutting inside, putting it over to Aquahomu. Juan Raul, bicycle clears it.
Yeah, what an...
Puts it back into the box. 5v1v faggot is wide.
It's like, this time, they really are getting attacks. That pass that got cleared, zero pressure on the Madoka player. That could have ended in a goal, but just no good passing options. But they are trying. They're now getting shots. Yeah. And suddenly, 3-0, that's not as much anymore.
Yeah, it doesn't seem like the obstacle it was before with all these dangerous attacks that have been coming on, but... You know, they have to convert some of these, unfortunately. And it does seem like the TF2G... Oh, wait, never mind. It looks like their attack is still going on.
Juan Raul gets it over to Kurt Cobain, grabbed by Guantanamo Bay.
Guantanamo Bay. I mean, maybe you don't want your goalkeeper to be like a prison because they're supposed to keep things in. They're not very good at keeping things out, I guess.
Well, I imagine you want a prison that keeps things out as well as it keeps things in, so nobody can break in and break somebody else out. 2 minutes of stoppage for the first half.
But man, every prison heist movie is like, oh, this prison is designed to keep things in, but not out, and then that's how they break in.
Deceived!
Oh,
saved! Kurt Cobain gets the follow-up! Oh, no. God.
Oh, man, we got to hear that goal horn, too. Man.
Oh, yeah, actually, it's 4 unanswered goals. Here's a new horn.
Oh, man.
You just got freaking dominated, Knucklehead. All right, let's do this.
Yeah, that's right.
Are you even trying?
Yo, did you even see me hitting you? Hey, Knucklehead, you ain't gonna win. It's starting to bore me how much you suck.
Look at you! You look like you ran through traffic!
Drink it in, pal. That's how failure tastes.
Would you look at you? I mean, look at you!
I don't usually kill morons this fast.
Look at this. Just caved in your skull. My bat's still dry. No clumps of hair. Nothing. Hit the bricks, pal. You're done. You are terrible. You're getting dominated, Chucklehead. Domination. Look it up. Is that all you got, moron?
Yeah, I dare you. Rage quit. Come on, make us both happy.
Oh, what, you gonna cry? You gonna cry now?
I will never stop killing you. And next time, try two eyes.
Blow that up, Cyclops.
The best man won, you bomb-throwing drunk.
Your clock just got cleaned, rummy.
Depth perception, pal. Look into it.
Hey, here's something you can invent next time. Ducking.
Here's something you should have built. A not-dying machine.
Don't bring a wrench to a gunfight.
Here's a schematic for you. My ass!
Hey, overalls! You
suck! that's the end of the half. It's 4-0 for TF2G.
Well,
that's the way to rub salt in the wounds.
Just a continuous stream of all the domination voice clips from TF2.
Man. Can you imagine if, like, the Madoka anime was, like, playing in, like, it would just interject with all the TF2T quotes. Like, whenever they start crying, it's just like, oh, wow, you're going to cry now?
God. Mercenaries are assholes. God. But, yeah, PMMM aren't doing super hot right now. I mean, they've woken up. They've certainly gotten back on track, I think. But TF2G just put in that effort early on and are securing themselves pretty much.
Yeah, they really came out to play. They just really, really, really wanted to advance this time.
They
really
wanted to get 7 points, yeah.
I don't know why they didn't do this last time or the last couple of times, but now they decided to show up and play.
All right, PMMM have some changes at the half. They want to go. They want to turn on. Is this an attack style? Yep, Tiki-Taka. And centering targets.
Well, there's one thing you do when you're losing.
Remove Gigan.
Just turn on those centering targets.
Mm-hmm. You want to go back to center. And positioning to flex. Alright, anything else for you?
Well, you know, maybe this is just like the timeline where everything goes bad, and by the end of this, you know, that's when they, you know, Homer goes back in time and tries to fix this or something.
Yep, new timeline's needed. Gonna have to try again.
Oh, there's VGLX, so.
There is VGLX in summer, yeah. I mean, if, whatever the fuck that DRM was, or whatever the hell that, Aniplex put on the game didn't kill your general, I doubt it'll die anytime soon.
Maybe in this team there's some holdouts who didn't make a contract with the Cube. Now they will after this. I don't know. But like I said earlier, I think kicking around Cube is not good for PMMM because Cube will just fuck their shit up.
Cube is not really in the habit of fucking shit up. Except for when you make a contract with him.
Yeah, right.
I mean, doing damage to him doesn't really seem to affect anything.
I'm sure he's still mad about it. Like, I'm sure he doesn't die, but he's like, man.
No, the time like, he got I, shot like, up, he wasn't very upset about it.
Well, he has a face that doesn't show he's mad, but I'm sure, like...
He talked to...
Internally, he's...
She really shot the shit out of him. He was like, whatever, I have more bodies.
Like, he looks like he's not mad, but inside he's really, really mad.
Might be. I don't know if he's capable of anger, to be honest.
We don't even know what he is, so...
needs an incubator. Whatever that means. Nothing. Oh, that's a blunder by the defense! Oh, and it didn't cost them.
That would have been a cheeky as fuck goal there.
That would have been cheeky. That was a defensive blunder as fuck. But luckily, he was just off target for luckily for PMMM.
Yeah, it's lucky that he didn't try to pass it. He just tried to go for the curler or something.
Yeah, that would have been a free tap-in for Pootis, but no. Wanted to go for it himself.
Yeah, I think he's the one who hasn't scored so far, I don't think. So maybe he wanted to go for himself.
Yeah, fair.
Long ball up to Aquahomu, headed away by the defense. Pyro update fucking never goes back with it.
It really has slowed down after those halftime changes.
We're going to do subs for TF2G real quick. Just they're most tired. So that's going to be Muselcat from TF2GU. Let's see. I think we'll do the left back and right back.
I don't know if TF2G will ever fix their aesthetics, but I hope they don't change the portraits. I love this, honestly.
9 HP scout. And we'll put in Miss Pauling.
Yeah, just keep Pyro update in there, why not?
Yeah. Let me know when you would like subs, Madoka, unless you've already... Nope. Let me know. Here's Pootis, on the touchline, loses the ball to Lulibaba. Nice ball up to Aquahomu. 5v1 me, faggot! 5v1 me, faggot!
Oh, yes.
Wait,
oh,
what?
No.
Wait, did it go in?
What?
Oh, fuck. Roost. It was outside the net.
Yeah, I guess so. I guess the ball was clipped.
Wait, hold on.
I think the ball clipped into
the net.
It's
not offsides. Oh, yeah, that was an optical illusion.
Oh, no.
Wow, that was... Oh, my God. That was an ultimate ruse, because I didn't hear a whistle, so I was like, that's goal, right?
Just nothing going their way. Nothing at all.
I'm telling you, man, QB is just purposely rigging this game, so PMM will...
You're not going to win unless you make a contract, goddammit.
Yeah, basically.
5v1 me faggot is able to get in! There's a goal!
There we go.
There we go! 4v1 me faggot! It's 4-1. Comebacks on, lads.
Apparently.
Madoka want to do their subs now. Gorilla Leader will be coming out for Mysterious Heroine of 0% gotcha rate. I think they need their gotcha luck here. Oh. Okay. Lulibaba coming out for the Chinese Wolverine. And
man, they have a lot of dead defenders here.
Well, yeah, Gigan will do that to you.
Oh, did they have Gigan?
They did. They turned it off. But Renekasu coming out for 5 out of 10 fried rice.
Did they forget to do the subs in the beginning of the game? Because I feel like there were better conditions on the bench before all this started.
They didn't give me any instructions for subs at the beginning.
Yeah, I mean, I'm sure they'll be back next time, but next time, you shouldn't forget to, put in best condition subs if you want to do that in the next time. It helps a little. It doesn't really help too much, but...
Yeah, implying conditions matter! It's far wide.
Oh, wow. Instant reminder that it's not going to be easy. The comeback's possible, okay, but you're not going to get it that free.
Yeah, now with TF2G's offense still being turned on like that.
Yeah, at some point, Madoka's going to have to start going even more aggressive, and that's when it gets really worrying with this TF2 offense. It's going to take half a miracle at this point if they want back.
Yeah, they need 4 in 15 minutes, basically.
I mean, we've seen it in this very game, but still, this late, these players are dead.
Yeah, they're all dying because of the Gigan. It's going to be... I will be very impressed. Please impress me.
Well, they're trying. That's a low pressure.
Easy mode support crossing it over, but it's over 5v1 me faggot's head. And again, over her head.
Oh, this could lead to a counter here. This is not good.
Oh, here's Pootis. Oh, wait. Pootis kind of stops with it. Getting
dogged.
Yeah, so
he has no one to pass it to.
Has to go over to TF2 GU, and that'll be a corner.
Oof. Well, we'll see how they defend this. Oh wow, what a long header.
Pootis kind of puts it into the air.
What was this?
I don't know. That's heroics from the keeper.
Oriko was right, tried to clear it, but Pootis got his foot on it first, but just kind of lobbed it up.
So he tried to shoot it, but like, it looked like what defenders do when they try to clear the ball instead of shooting it. What a bizarre turn of events there. A
little bit of spaghetti. And TF2 slowly making their way up the wing once again. 9 HP scout misses the head on that, and it's out. Free throwing. Eventually.
Okay, I guess they're a bit confused on who got the header or who got the throw in there.
Oh boy, over the bar.
Did the goalkeeper get the hand to that?
Yep. The keeper was able to bounce it into the air over the bar. But they get a corner out of this. TF2. They're going to take it short. Way over to 9 HP. Scout takes the shot. It's wide. Big slap.
I think it deflected off a guy.
He might have. That was really close. And that, the ball trajectory was really weird. But apparently not. It was just a really weird shot.
Mm-hmm. Well, there's 5 minutes plus extra time now.
I mean, surely still doable.
5v1, me faggot. Puts it back over to Mysterious, heroine of 0% gotch rate. 0% goal rate.
That was a gimme. That was a free goal right there. That was a beautiful setup. And
that would have been a pretty mean goal. But
I mean, this was a nice back heel. And that was very unfortunate that that did not go in.
Yeah, that's really how their attack has been. They've had chances, but so many of them have been just barely missed.
Mm-hmm.
They're also having a little difficulty keeping this in the box, like that last time. Yeah.
Excuse me. Why, Homu? Why?
Homu just kind of. They're having a lot of difficulty getting that final touch inside the box.
Turns out all they need to do is buy some more gacha. I'll fix it.
Just buy spend more some contracts. More money. That'll fix it. Make a contract, sign up, get some money so you can roll the gacha some more.
Yep.
4 minutes of stoppage. And it's looking
we
like
we could have a double spade.
Oh, that's a dead player there.
Because this is going to be basically like a corner.
It's oh, a yellow it's a for corner. The mysterious heroine of 0% gacha rate.
Spooky ghost card.
Yeah. Butis trying to free kick. It's headed away by Aroha. 9 HP scout over the bar.
That's way over the bar.
And they have a minute for something to happen. Easy mode support. Gets it over to Mysterious Heroine. Back to easy mode support. Chinese Wolverine. Loses the ball with a tackle. That should be it. Yep.
Wow.
Lads, I think it's fair to say that being Maguka is suffering.
Yeah.
But that is it. 4-1 for TF2G. And TF2G have broken their curse. They have finally made it out of the qualifiers and into the VGL proper.
Yes, after spooning three so they play four qualifiers now. Three of them they've spooned. and now they're actually finally advanced for one, so that's really surprising. Congrats to them.
Yeah, according to the match details, they've only done two qualifiers, but they did spoon both of those.
I mean, I guess the first VGL did have qualifiers, but that was still a spoon.
Oh, was it?
Still.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Way back in the day. Yeah, I mean, it's not like TF2 didn't deserve it either. 12-6 to 6-2.
I mean, their crossing game early on was just devastating. I don't think, even though POTUS was like man marked, he got a couple goals from the crosses.
Not only was he man marked, he was type marked.
Oh, really?
He was both. Didn't seem to really affect much, though, as far as I could tell, though. Man of the match, Butis with a 7.
Butis. Yeah, not surprising.
Kurt Cobain also getting a 7. Kyoko and the other Homu, the Moe Homu, also getting 6-5s.
And, you know, I would tell the people running PMMM, you know, this is suffering. This is just part of the game. And I think the more you suffer through it, eventually you'll find some sort of hope of advancing. Because, I mean, it took TF2G 9 times to do that.
Yeah,
I mean,
look at your opponent here, all right, for an example. They have suffered quite a bit in the past, and they finally made something of themselves. So, you know, like, your first outing, not so hot, you didn't break out of qualifiers, but by all means come back next time for VGLX, the extreme one, this summer. But, match details. At 7 minutes, Putis from MyEpic. At 13 minutes, Putis from Juan Raul Rodriguez, 2009. At 16 minutes, Kurt Cobain's last microphone from Swipes. And 45 plus 3, Kurt Cobain's last microphone unassisted. All of TF2G's goals were in the first half. And 3 of them were in the first 20 minutes.
Yeah, that was kind of a rough series. Rough 20 minutes.
Mm-hmm. 68 minutes came your TF2G subs. At 71 minutes, 5v1 me faggot from implying 300 Magia chips. And then your subs came on for Madoka. A 90 plus 3 yellow card for Mysterious Heroine of 0% gacha rate. And that's it. Attacking areas. Ball winning areas. A lot of ball winning areas.
Wow.
For both these teams.
Wow, that's like... like all of them, for TF2G almost are like on their side of the pitch.
Yeah, they're just
jeez,
good to
so
get
scared
it away before the. Yeah, that's again, like I said, the magical girls were having difficulty making that final touch in the box. That's what that is. But that is going to do it for Group A. Your two teams advancing are TF2G with 7 points and AGDG with 5 points. And Puella Magi, Madoka Magica, and Shadowverse come back in the summer for VGLX. Who knows what the fuck we're going to do. Maybe it'll be Mega VGL. I don't know.
Mega VGL?
That'd be neat.
Just have like a Babby VGL and an Elite VGL.
Yeah, just make our own tournament. Goddamn.
Yeah, get every single team to sign up.
All right, well, that's going to do it for this one. We're going to listen to the TF2G anthem as their victory anthem. And we're going to move on to Group B, our first match, which is Visual Novel versus WTG. Thank you both for commentating.
Yeah, no problem.
Thanks for having us.
See you later.
Bye.
Here we go. All right. Here we go. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Hey guys, it's Silky again. I've just been ruling my kingdom. It's been pretty sweet. Except for one problem. It's lonely being a king. Where are all the good girls? So much trash around. I just want someone to cuddle.